Hey all, here at OS Reviews. In this video, we are taking a closer look at the Boldtune Active Noise Cancelling Bluetooth headphones. They have a pretty classy color scheme, having this brown and also metallic silver accent, very different from the typical black headphones that we see at this price point, and it has up to 30 hours of playback time, 20 hours if you are using it with active noise cancelling turned on. They claim to cancel out up to 96% of ambient background noise, and also they have a quick charge function so that you can charge them for 5 minutes and they will last for around 2 hours or so. Now, the only slight quirk is the price, at least right now, is a little bit on the high side. It sells for $90 on Amazon with free shipping. That's still relatively inexpensive if you're comparing it with tier 1 brands like Sony or Bose and their Quiet Comfort line. However, competitors like Tautronix and BlueDio with their Turbine series are definitely cheaper than these right now. For example, the Turbine T7s will sell for about $20 cheaper. Contents include a hard shell carrying case, which is a pretty nice extra touch, and it has the headphones folded down inside, which we'll take a closer look at in a second. Accessories include a micro USB cable for charging. We also have an adapter with a 3.5mm jack and an airplane adapter if you want to use them as wired headphones. Taking a closer look at the design of these Boldtune headphones first, it definitely has a very kind of retro throwback vibe to it because of its color scheme, and it does have a very generous layer of padding, which is made out of protein leather or memory foam for both the headband as well as for the cushions around your ears. So on the plus side, it does look very premium. On the side here, we do have access to a dedicated volume rocker, which is pretty tactile and responsive, auxiliary port if you want to use it as wired headphones, LED indicator light, here's a power key that you can tap on for a few seconds to turn it on, and on the other side, there's a switch for active noise canceling that can be turned on regardless of if you are using it in the Bluetooth mode or not. Here's a profile of the earphones from the side. A quick size comparison, here are the aforementioned BlueDio Turbines T7s, which are a bit cheaper, but also have, again, active noise cancelling on board, and also are over-the-ear style, so both have pretty large cushions. The Boldtune are even a little bit larger than the BlueDio as far as giving you more depth to the cushions, so they're ultra comfortable and soft. And then on-ear style active noise cancelling headphones, the Liner NC80s, which we reviewed a few months back, you can see a lot smaller in terms of the cup size. Moving to sound quality, overall these are quite impressive. The 45mm drivers are large, and as a result pack in a great amount of depth and bass. So if you really enjoy kind of bass-boosted tracks, EDM-type music with lots of drum beats, they really come to life. If you're watching a soundtrack, a movie, everything kind of rumbles in the lower frequencies. Bluetooth 5.0 allows the battery life to be pretty good and also ensures that the latency is great. So you can play and pause a track really quickly on the phone or tablet, and it still stays synced really well with the audio. Also, I would say that the hi-fi audio claims do get pretty close. There's very little hints of distortion or static, so even if you listen super closely, they still are nearly silent. When the volume is low or you're playing and pausing the sound, it just feels extremely smooth, and as a result, it just feels like you're almost using wired headphones. So it's quite impressive how they were able to eliminate lots of those signs of digital noise or distortion in the background. So kudos to Boldtune, and I think that using the latest chipsets are definitely helping them. Otherwise, mids and highs still sound reasonably well balanced and give you plenty of detail to listen to as well. Now moving into the active noise canceling part, I would say it's effective, but still not to the tier of, say, Bose's Quiet Comfort series. You can definitely feel a difference when you switch it on, and lower frequency sounds like engines, fan noises, if you're at an airport, all of those are dramatically reduced. But people talking and sounds which are at a medium frequency or have a higher frequency, trebles, are not really blocked out. Compared to the BlueDio T7s, I would say the active noise canceling works slightly better on these, just because you're using the latest hybrid ANC technology, and ANC is actually a slight weakness on the BlueDio Turbine series in general. It is worth noting that turning on active noise cancellation does add some more noise into the background, so it's not going to be quite as pure or distortion-free as when you have it off. That's when you're going to get the best audio quality. Here you can still hear a little bit of a hiss that's very gentle. Otherwise, what's interesting here is it doesn't seem to really change the sound profile as much as on other pairs of budget ANC headphones. Brands like Tautronix or MPOW On those, it seemed like bass was kind of missing, and whenever you turned on active noise cancellation, it kind of punched up the bass. On these, they're actually not quite as significant. Even with the ANC turned off, again, bass was already quite good, simply because, again, they're using a pretty large driver and the latest chipsets. With ANC switched on, it does tend to increase the volume a little bit more, which makes sense. It tries to make the music, you know, the center point of your attention, but at the same time, it doesn't dramatically change the equalizer or punch up the bass that much more. So that's the Boltune ANC wireless Bluetooth headphones. Overall, I think they get a lot right. The active noise canceling, I would say, is above average for relatively inexpensive headphones. Overall, they work very well, they're extremely comfortable, sound quality is great, especially with bass, and they give you plenty of detail in the regular listening mode. Battery life is also, again, above average, along with the styling, I think, is really on point with the color scheme and the fact that it just looks really classy and has a retro vibe. So you can check out more details if you're interested in the links down below, but for now, that's been our video. Thanks for watching here at OS Reviews. That's been the Boltune ANC wireless Bluetooth headphones.